Good evening. On behalf of the Dallas Chapter of the American Guild of Organists and the AGO, we welcome you to the Southwest Opening Worship Service. My name is Renee Schmidt. I'm coordinator for the convention. We are honored by your presence. The steering committee has been meeting monthly for the past 2 years to plan this event, and we thank them for their dedication to the task. In commemoration of the 500th anniversary of the Lutheran Reformation, we have chosen as our opening worship service a Lutheran Vespers service as it might have been practiced in Germany in the generations immediately following Luther. Music for Luther was a way to inspire the faithful and convince the unrepentant. Subsequent composers studied musical rhetoric devices, much like a speechwriter, to sway the listener. Music, as we know in our profession, can move the spirit and restore the faith. We are indebted to Barbara Bradfield for making this Vesper service possible. It is dedicated to the memory of her late husband, John Bradford. John was a seminal member of the Dallas AGO, and we still mourn our loss. Barbara is a wonderful supporter of the arts. If you have ever been to her fabulous house, it is filled with a pipe organ, a grand piano, great art, and gemütlichkeit, a word that roughly translates as friendship and comfort. Thank you, Barbara. We also thank King of Glory interim pastor, the Reverend Dr. Gary Johnson, and his staff for hosting this event. Michael Shake is the director of music, and his support has been crucial. He also serves as our Dallas Dean and is organist for this event. He and his wife, Laura, underwrote the jazz concert we just heard in the Fellowship Hall. We are also honored by the presence of Bishop Erik Gronberg, the presiding bishop of the Lutheran Synod of North Texas and North Louisiana. And now, please silence your phone and allow the music and the liturgy to speak.
Thank you. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, the 10th chapter. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that Christ is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So we ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God. Let us pray. O God, on this day you open the hearts of your faithful people by sending into us your Holy Spirit. Direct us by the light of that Spirit, that we may have a right judgment in all things and rejoice at all times in your peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.